So, Pap, the lot of Republican insanity to report on, it wasn't all just at CPAC this past week. There was a story. We should be really careful here, too, because I don't want
Janine. Yeah.
Janine's cousin, actually, Pat Garofalo, to get caught up in this. He's a an editor over at U.S. News.
And but, not the representative Pat Garofalo Republican nut.
Indeed. Well, this guy, he's a Minnesota lawmaker. His name is Representative Pat Garofalo. And
spelled the same, by the way.
It's spelled the same, but he's talking now that if I mean I don't know what inspired this tweet, frankly, but you know it's stunning. This is
well,
I
no, what
say,
inspired
just,
it was CPAC. This right. brought out the every crazy felt empowered. They felt emboldened when they heard all the crazy McConnell and Bachman and Coulter. And when they hear all the crazies, they're emboldened. So pick it up from there.
Well, yeah, I think you're absolutely right about that, because and the sad thing for Republicans is that they have access to Twitter and video exists now that can be widely disseminated.
How do you do that with just thumbs, though? I don't get it. But anyway, go ahead.
Well, maybe they do that speak to text technology. But so this guy, Representative Pat Garofalo, tweets, let's be honest, 70% of teams in NBA could fold tomorrow and nobody would notice a difference, with possible exception of increase in street crime. He was asked to come on to a Minneapolis TV station, you know, to face the claims, the obvious claims, that it was a racially tinged tweet. And he goes, well, I was talking about the NBA's high arrest rate. Now, this is just absurd. There's a huge arrest rate. Well, I don't know that's huge. I don't know that's huge in NBA, but there's a pretty big arrest rate in football. You see problems in baseball. I mean, you see it.
Well, lacrosse. How about lacrosse? How about Duke lacrosse team?
Yeah, indeed. And he says, I really don't understand how being critical of a culture of pro athletes has anything to do with race. This is a behavior that transcends the race of the athlete and seems to be a culture in all professional sports.
Okay,
these days.
Let me ask you something. Do these Republicans who now are being told to use tweet by leadership, use tweet, do they not know that other people read the tweets, or do they think that they're just tweeting to – I mean, what do they not know that when you put a tweet out there, people read it?
Well, Pap, I mean,
when they go on – and they're on television speaking, that people might be actually seeing they're speaking on television.
I think you're absolutely right about CPAC. I mean, I think what happens is whether they're there or not, as that's going on, it increases their delusion level, where they actually think this is the mainstream perspective of America. And, you know, undoubtedly, you know, this guy might be more at home down in the South. But when you're in the Republican Party, when you're a Republican lawmaker, you are trapped in this world where you think it's, you know, 1963 or something. And we're living in a much more regressive world. And you know, if you're one of those economic conservatives, maybe you're hoping that we're living closer to the late 1800s or the early 1900s, or I should say 2000s. But, you know, this is also, you know, we talked about Wayne LaPierre at CPAC. This is more of the same about these cultural touchstones.